linear algebra, the first unit is vector spaces. Now we know the idea of a group, and we studied about the group axioms. So we define the term vector spaces. Here the system, that is the algebraic system, V over the operation addition and multiplication, the algebraic system V over the operation addition and multiplication, this is the operation over a field F. F is the field, is a vector space, is a vector spaces which satisfies the different properties. So the first property that we say V1 for this vector space, operations are addition and multiplication. Over these operation, now V plus V over addition. V over addition is a commutative group, or is an abelian group. Abelian group means it's all properties of group along with the property of commutativity. Now second, that is V2, here A dot, this is operation of multiplication, B dot, we can say V. Now here A dot B dot V is equal to A dot B dot V, which satisfies the property of associativity for all V belonging to the vector space V. For all V belonging to the vector space V. Now the third, V3, A dot B or V plus W, we can say A dot V plus W, which is equal to A dot V plus A dot W, where V and W, which belongs to the V, which satisfies the distributivity, where V and W, which all belongs to the vector space V. Now the last, fourth property here, 1 dot V, 1 dot V is equal to V. Now 1 dot V is equal to V, where 1 is the unit element of F. So using this definition is vector space V over the addition and multiplication, V plus is an abelian group, then it satisfies the property of associativity, again it satisfies the property of distributivity, and the unit element, that is 1 dot V, is equal to V, where 1 is the unit element of F. Now using this definition, using this concept of a vector space, we prove a certain theorem. Now the theorem 1, which is very important theorem, let U plus V belongs to U. Let u plus v belongs to u. U plus v belongs to u, b a vector spaces. Then the first part, that is alpha into 0 is equal to 0. Alpha 0 is equal to 0 for all alpha belonging to F. For all alpha belonging to the F. Now we prove this theorem. Alpha 0 is equal to 0. Very important. Using the definition that is just we proved earlier, just we written earlier, v1, v2, v3, v4, we using this one, the first alpha. Now 0 can be written as 0 plus 0. 0, this can be written as 0 plus 0. So alpha 0 plus 0 can be written as alpha 0. Alpha 0 plus 0 is equal to alpha 0, because 0 is equal to 0 plus 0. Can we write this? 0 is equal to 0 plus 0. Any difficulty? Now 0 plus 0, this also belongs to the vector space V. Means alpha 0 plus 0 is equal to alpha 0, where this 0 plus 0 is equal to 0, which belongs to V. Now alpha 0 plus 0, this can be written as alpha 0 plus alpha 0 is equal to alpha 0. Alpha 0 plus alpha 0 is equal to alpha 0 here by distributivity. Again, this is alpha 0 plus alpha 0 is equal to alpha 0 plus 0. Alpha 0, because 0 is equal to the identity. 0 is equal to the identity. Now, using both the right and left side, by using the cancellation law, here we use the left cancellation law, because it is very simple. Alpha 0 into alpha 0 plus alpha 0 is equal to alpha 0 plus 0. 0 is the identity. Now by left cancellation law, this alpha 0 and alpha 0, this is cancelled, and the remaining terms are alpha 0 is equal to alpha 0 get cancelled here, and alpha 0 is equal to 0. So we arrive at the result alpha 0 is equal to 0. We proved the result 1. Similarly, now here alpha belongs to F over the field F. Now similarly, a slight change in the second part, 0 V is equal to 0. Now what about 0 V? What is the main difference between alpha 0 and 0 V? Here V, which belonging to the vector space V. This small V, which belongs to the vector space V. Now using the similar lines, using the first part, again we prove by using the similar lines. Now 0 V, again this is 0 plus 0 into V. But 0 plus 0, this is equal to 0 V. Now use the distributivity. 0 V plus 0 V is equal to 0 V by distributivity. Now 0 V plus 0 V is equal to 0 V. Again, the same thing plus 0. Again, what this 0 character is? 0 here is belonging to the vector space V. Again, by left cancellation law, 0 dot V is equal to 0 by left cancellation law. Now, by left cancellation law, 0 V is equal to 0, and here we arrive at the result, second one. Now, using this similar first and second part, we can solve the remaining parts. The third one is minus alpha into v is equal to alpha into minus v. We derive this result, minus alpha into v is equal to alpha v. Now, here alpha and v, alpha is belonging to the F. Alpha is belonging to the F. F is the field. So, alpha plus minus alpha. We just add and subtract the term, that is V plus minus of V. Further, alpha plus and minus of alpha, it is 0 into V. 0 into V. Again, use the property of distributivity. Alpha V over the operation dot plus minus alpha V is equal to 0. Now, alpha V minus alpha V is equal to 0. Now, here we write the property of distributivity. So, this minus of alpha V by transposing, this becomes equal to minus alpha minus alpha V. Now, we write the term, because here alpha V minus of alpha V, alpha this becomes 0, alpha V minus of alpha V is equal to 0 V, this against the 0. So, alpha V minus alpha. Now, here this alpha, which is the inverse of this term, is the inverse of this alpha. So, which is equal to alpha of minus of V. Okay, you are getting all these three results. The definition of the vector space, which satisfies the property of commutativity, that is the abelian group, then associativity, then distributivity, and the unit elements. Now, using the definition of the vector space, we derived the result, all these three results, which are alpha 0 is equal to 0, 0 into V is equal to 0, and minus alpha V is equal to alpha of minus V. All these are the results which are based on the vector spaces.